Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we are going to study the 6th standard maths chapter number 10, equations. What are the equations? The equations are the mathematical terms in which both the hand sides, that is RHS and the LHS, are equal to each other. In the equation, it is compulsory that both the hand sides should have equal values. Hence, they are also known as equality. For example, here it is written x is equals to 1. So here the x have a value of 1. That means what? 1 is equals to x. So here the RHS means this part of the equation, that is RHS, that is right hand side, is equals to the LHS, that is left hand side. So whenever the two hand side, that is right hand side and the left hand side, are equal to each other, at that time the terms in the maths is called as equality or a equation. So for here the terms like x, sometimes it is used as y, sometimes z, sometimes a, sometimes b or c. So these all the alphabets which are used in the equation are called as variables. What they are called as? They are called as variables. These variables have a changing value. Why they are called as variables? Because the value can be changed with the time and as per the need. Means the value of x can be changed, y can be changed, z can be changed, a, b and c, or even the other alphabets can be changed during the solution of the equations. So that's why these all are called as variables. While the numbers which are used in the equation as 1, 2 and so on, so like that way, these all the numbers are said as coefficient. What they are called as? Coefficient. These coefficients have their own constant value, which is not at all going to be changed. Matlab 1 ka value, 2 ka value, ya phir 3, 4, ya isi tarah se kisi bhi number ka value jo hai equation mein kabhi bhi change nahi hota hai. Isiliye in sare numbers ko hum coefficient kehte hain. Jabke x, y, z ya phir koi aur alphabet hai to uska value jo hai change hota hai. In sare alphabets ko hum variables kehte hain. Equations ka ye compulsory rule hai ke right hand side aur left hand side jo hai wo ek dusre ke equal hona chahiye. और इसीलिए जो है इक्वेशंस कहा जाता है इन्हें, क्योंकि ये दोनों जो है दोनों साइड को इक्वल तौर पर जो है रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. Now here the question we are having, identify the equality and an equation from the given table. So this is the table which is given as the question number 1, C part. So here in the table, first one is given to us as P minus 3 is equals to 8. So this is the question given to us. From that we are supposed to find out that it is a equation or the equality. Now see here. So whenever we are able to find or we are finding the equation and the equality, we are supposed to keep in mind that equation may have any other values also. Matlab equations ki bahut sare different values ho sakti hai, lekin equality agar hum koi cheez ki dhoond rahe hai to humko ye dhyan rakhna zaruri hai ke us equation ke liye left hand side aur right hand side dono side ka equal hona zaruri hai. मतलब दोनों एक दूसरे के सिमिलर होना चाहिए. सो हियर वी आर हैविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ फर्स्ट वन एज p माइनस 3. सो नाउ हियर इफ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व, सो इट विल बी p माइनस 3. सो दिस माइनस 3 विल गो ओवर हियर विद द 8. सो इट विल बिकम p इज इक्वल्स टू 8 प्लस 3 इज इक्वल्स टू 5. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ p इज इक्वल्स टू 5. सो हियर इट विल बी द equation. The first one is an equation. The first one is an equation and not the equality. So equation ke column mein hum yahan par likhenge, jahan par equation hai wahan par hum tick mark karenge, and in the column of equality we will cross mark it. Aur ye solution jo hai aapko kya karna hai, वर्कबुक में आपके स्पेस नहीं दिया हुआ है, बट यू आर सपोज टू राइट डाउन दिस ऑन अ पेपर एंड देन द पेपर शुड बी स्टक इन द बुक. मतलब आपको क्या करना है, एक पेज पर जो सॉल्यूशन हम करवा रहे हैं टेबल का वो एक पेजेस पे लिखना है, और पेजेस पे लिखने के बाद आपको क्या करना है उसका सही तरीके से सॉल्यूशन लिखने के बाद उस पेज को जो है आपको वर्कबुक में स्टिक करना है. सो द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन वी आर हैविंग हियर, 5 = 40/8. So here this 8 is in the division with the 40. So here we are going to take this with the 5. So it will be becoming 5 × 8 = 40. So therefore 40 = 40. How it will be 40? 5 × 8 = 40. So here 40 = 40. So therefore it is equal on both the hand side. That is RHS is equals to the LHS. So therefore this is an equality. समझ में आया? ये क्या है हमारे लिए? Equality है. तो हम इसको जो है क्या करेंगे? Equations के कॉलम में क्रॉस मार्क करेंगे और equality के कॉलम में हम इसको टिक मार्क करेंगे. Now let us go with the third one. The third one is given to you. 9 - 3 = 4+2. Now 4+2 here we are going to solve like that way. We will solve first of all RHS. हम सबसे पहले जो है right hand side पे जो provided है हम उसको solve करेंगे. So it is 9 - 3. Here it will be exactly 6. Similar way we are going to solve the LHS which is equals to 4+2 = 6. So therefore RHS is equals to LHS. So hence we are having both the sides equal to each other. Hence this is an equality. So for the column of equality we will tick mark, and for the column of equation we will cross mark. Now here we are having the fourth example as 4a - 3 = 21. Hai na? So here 4a is equals to this 3 we are taking with the 21. So it will become 21 + 3. So it will be 4a = 24. So therefore a is equals to this 4 will go with the 24 to become in the division. So here it will be a = 24/4. 4 × 1 = 4, 4 × 6 = 24. So therefore a = 6. है ना? तो यानी ये जो है हमारा इक्वालिटी नहीं है बल्कि ये क्या है? इक्वेशन है. तो इसके लिए हम इसको इक्वेशन के कॉलम में क्या करेंगे? टिक मार्क करेंगे एंड इक्वालिटी के कॉलम में हम इसको क्रॉस मार्क करेंगे. नाउ द लास्ट फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन यू आर हैविंग एज 5 = 7/8, इजंट इट? तो यहाँ पर जो है किस तरह से होगा, ये a को पहले हम उठा करके किसके पास ले आएंगे? 5 के पास लेकर आएंगे. सो इट विल बिकम 5a = 7. देन दिस टू टुगेदर आर इन द मल्टीप्लीकेशन, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी विल टेक दिस 5 ओवर हियर. सो इट विल बिकम्स a = 7/5. सो अगेन दिस वन इज द इक्वेशन एंड नॉट द इक्वालिटी. तो इस तरह से जो है हमने ये फर्स्ट टेबल को कंप्लीट किए. नाउ लेट अस गो विद द नेक्स्ट टेबल वी आर हैविंग एज अ नाउ यू आर हैविंग अनदर क्वेश्चन इन योर वर्क बुक. रीड राइट द फॉलोइंग यूजिंग अ लेटर. नाउ हियर यू आर सपोज टू गिव इन सम ऑफ द नंबर्स. सो देर यू आर सपोज टू राइट डाउन द इक्वेशंस, मतलब आपको इक्वेशंस को फॉर्म आउट करना है. सो द फर्स्ट वन इज गिवन टू यू द सम ऑफ अ सर्टेन नंबर एंड 3, मतलब एक नंबर ऐसा है जिसमें आपको 3 ऐड करना है, एडिशन करना है. तो यहाँ पर क्या करेंगे हम? फर्स्ट वाले को इस तरह से लिखेंगे x + 3 लाइक दैट वे. एंड द सेकेंड वन यू आर हैविंग द डिफरेंस obtained by subtracting 11 from the another number. Now यहाँ पर आपको क्या बोल रहा है कि दो नंबर का डिफरेंस जो है वो किस तरह से मिलता है? अगर एक नंबर में से हम 11 को निकाल दे, यानी कि सब्ट्रैक्ट कर दे. तो इसको इस तरह से लिखेंगे y - 11. Then third one we will write down here the product of 15 and the another number, product of 15 and the another number, यहाँ पर आपको क्या दिया हुआ है, किसी number में आपको क्या करना है, 15 को multiply करना है. So here we are having z into 15. So this is the third equation. Now let us go with the fourth one. 4 times a number is 24. 4 times a number is 24. मतलब अगर आप किसी number को 4 times लेते हो, तो उसका 4 times कितना आता है? 24 आता है. So here 4 times A is equals to 24. Like that way we can write down. Now the fifth one we'll write down. Add 9 to the certain number. Now, it is given you to add a 9 into the certain number. So, certain number I am taking here as a M and then it should be added with the 9 to make an equation. Now, sixth one. The product of 20 and a certain number. Now, let us multiply the number with the 20. So, I am taking here T into 20. T into 20. Now let us go with the seventh one. It is given you 6 times a number is 60. Now similar way we are supposed to write down like a fourth one. Fourth mein aapne kaise liya tha? 4 times a number is 24 and here it is given 6 times a number is a 60. So here I am taking B 6B, because 6 times any number, so 6 times of a B is equals to 60. So 8th one over here given to you as thrice a number is 24, yani 3 times kisi number ko liya jayega to kitna ban jayega? 24 ban jayega. So I am having 3P is equals to 24. Ye hamara 8th one ho gaya. Now let us go for the 9th one. The 9th one is given to you as subtracting 15 from a certain number gives the 25. Now agar kisi number mein se 15 ko subtract kiya jata hai to answer mein humko kitna milta hai? 25. So here we are going to write down q minus 15 is equals to 25, like that way. So here we have made the 9 and the 10th one. Let us go with the 10th one. Here the 10th question is dividing a number by 8 gives 2. Now here one of a number is there which is going to be divided by that 8. So the answer will obtain by 2. So I am having a number as N upon 8 is equals to 2.